Previously, I shared 5 tricks you didn't know about DUIK, and people really seemed to like that video. So in this video, I'm gonna share 4 more. This video is brought to you by Envato Elements. Stay tuned later in the video and I'll show you how you can get up to 50% off an entire year subscription to Envato Elements. Now, before we really get started, I'm gonna give you a little bit of a freebie. DUIK has different modes. It has rookie, standard, expert, and God mode. As you move up in these modes, mostly things like the UI changes, but you also get access to some settings that aren't there in these other modes. There are a few things in this video that we'll talk about that are only accessible in certain modes, so I'll make sure to call those out as we go along.
To change the mode, click on this little wrench icon at the bottom, and then click through the modes up here. I suggest being set to standard at the very least, particularly for what we'll cover in this video. With that out of the way, let's get the ball rolling.
In my previous video, which you can and should go watch, link in the description, we went over how you can extract controllers within a composition to reduce the number of layers in your current timeline. Well, I thought we could dive a little bit deeper into this feature because there is so much more to show you. This feature has 2 modes that you can access by clicking on this little dot next to the option. You can either use master properties if you're using After Effects 2018 or later, or you can use expressions. So which one should you use and why? Okay, so the cool thing about using master properties is that it allows you to reuse your character rig in multiple different compositions. You can just rig up your character once and animate 100 different animations without needing to re-rig anything 100 times. Unfortunately though, performance does seem to take a little bit of a hit when using master properties. So, if you want to maintain performance, I've found, based on several different tests that I've performed, extracting your controllers using expressions rather than master properties yielded much better performance. However, beware that if you're using expressions, you can't reuse the original composition in another scene. If you want to use the same rig in multiple scenes, you'd have to duplicate that original composition before extracting the controllers. Essentially, if you want to animate 100 different scenes using the same rig, you'd have to have 100 duplicates of that original composition. So let me show you an example of how we can utilize the extracting controllers in some unique ways. Here I have an arm rig, and the arm on the reference artwork has an outline. However, I don't want the outline of my forearm to overlap the bicep like it does in this character rig example. So, what I've done here to solve this is I've pre-composed the arm layers and rigged them inside of that pre-comp. Then, back in the original composition, I'll add a stroke layer style to the composition. And then I'll go over to DUIK and extract the controller using master properties. Now the arm works just like it normally would, but now the outline outlines the whole arm and doesn't overlap the bicep. Now here's something really neat. I want to rig up the other arm, but I don't want to have to duplicate everything like I just did. Well, check this out. I can duplicate that same arm composition and extract the controller. And I'll reiterate, this only works if you're using master properties. So once I've extracted, it'll pop up with this little warning that you can just ignore and hit OK. Now I have another arm all rigged up and ready to go that is referencing that same composition. Huge time saver. Character rigging in animation can be a lot. And it can be insanely frustrating to achieve good animation when you're working like this. So, anything you can do to improve performance is worth a shot, right? DUIK offers a few different ways you can try and improve the performance of your rigs. But first, to access these options, you gotta make sure that you're not in rookie mode. To change the mode, go down to the little wrench down here icon at the bottom, and then set to standard or expert, and then hit set. That way, you'll have access to these settings. Now, go to the controller panel, and down at the bottom, there will be an edit button. In here, you can choose to bake the appearance of your controller layers. Baking the appearance means that you're giving up the ability to make changes to the controller icon size, color, and position. All these attributes will be locked in, so make sure you make those changes beforehand. The reason why this improves performance is because all those attributes are driven by expressions, and expressions can really tax your system. So baking the look and removing those expressions can help optimize your composition. You can also set the defaults for controllers here as well. One thing I always have set as a default is the settings quality. I always have that set to draft. Of course, you can always manually change this in the timeline, but setting this as the default here just saves me a little time later. I just see no need for ultra crisp controller layers when in the end they aren't even rendered out anyway. You can also set the default to create null objects instead of icons for controller layers in order to speed things up even more. Icons created by DUIK for controller layers are shape layers, and shape layers are resource heavy because they have to be rasterized for every frame. So they have a tendency to really slow down your system. So if you're someone who's plagued by poor performance, I'd highly suggest setting your default to null objects and save any of your performance overhead for the shape layers that'll actually be rendered out in the end. Now, let me temper your expectations here. Though these optimizations are legit, they are not going to blow your hair back. They will improve performance, but they aren't miraculous. Let's jump back to that arm rig that we were working on earlier. I need to add a sleeve to this arm, but I don't want the whole thing to be outlined like my arm, so I can't include it inside the arm pre-comp, or else I will have the whole thing outlined. So I have to place it outside of the arm pre-comp in the current composition. But I need the sleeve to rotate with the arm, particularly the bicep. But because my bicep layer is inside of this composition, there's nothing really to parent to. Well, that is where the parent across comps comes in handy. To set this up, first I'll select the layer I want to be the child. In this case, the sleeve layer. Then in DUIK, I'll go to parent across comp to open up the options. In the first section, I'll select the composition which contains the layer that you want to parent to. In my case, it's the arm composition. After you've selected the composition, you'll then be able to select the layer within that composition you want to parent to. So I'll select the arm layer because that is what I named the bicep. I know I probably shouldn't have named so many different things arm. Then all that I have to do now is click parent. DUIK will work its magic, and now you have a parent-child relationship that spans across the compositions, and the sleeve will follow the rotation of my arm. Also, if you want to parent other layers to that same layer, you don't have to go through that whole process again. You can just parent anything else that you need to parent to this null layer that DUIK created in the current composition. And if you want to unparent everything, all you have to do is set the parent to none on all the child layers, unlock this null layer, and delete it. And again, check this out. Because we use master properties to extract these controllers, I can actually parent another sleeve to the other arm using the extract locators button, even though it's referencing the same layer in the same composition. For this, I'll have to switch to expert mode though. So I'll go to the wrench at the bottom and I'll switch to expert mode and apply changes. Now I'll select my other arm composition. I'll go back to DUIK and go to the parent across comp options, which is now represented by just this little icon. And in these options, I'll click on extract locator. And this will create a new null object that represents the arm layer inside the composition at the top that I can then parent my other sleeve layer to, and now it will follow my rig. Pretty cool, right? And then, as before, if I want to plop this composition down in another composition, I can still extract the controllers even further. Before we finish with this last trick, I'm going to take a moment here to shout out this video's sponsor, Envato Elements. Envato Elements is an incredible resource for creators. I cannot tell you how much I've taken advantage of Envato Elements both in my freelance work and in creating content for this channel. All the character rigs that I've used for this video and other videos I've found in the graphics section of Envato Elements. These videos take me a lot of time to make, so anything that can save me time, like coming up with character designs, is a huge win. Envato Elements is super affordable. You can get an additional 50% off by signing up for an annual subscription rather than a month to month. And you can get access to literally millions of assets for less than $20 a month. Plus, they are always adding new content to an already massive library every week. Use the link in the description of this video to sign up and to support the channel. Okay, so here's a quick little animation I made of a lady sitting down. Now, bear with me, this animation is not complete, so it's really still kind of stiff, but I just want to demonstrate how I've used the switch from IK to FK to make this animation of her sitting, kicking her leg up, and then having the leg bob like this. So I want to start out in IK because as she sits down, I want her feet to stick to the floor. This is something that you really can only do if you're using IK. But as soon as she sat down and she starts to move her leg up, she kicks it up and then bobs it. This is something that you could animate with IK, but it's much easier to just do it with the FK settings. However, when I go up to IK to turn it off so that I can use the FK settings, you'll notice that all of a sudden the limb just shifts to being completely stiff, pointing downward. And that is because all the FK settings are all set to zero. Well, we can actually use the snap FK to IK to manipulate these FK settings so that when we switch to FK by switching off the IK, our limb will be in the exact position that it is now. So all you have to do is make sure that your controller is selected, go over to FK IK, click on this little dot next to it, which will bring up the three different options, click snap FK to IK, and boom, we now have keyframes on all the FK properties, and we have a keyframe to switch off the IK. And now we can go forward and animate the motion of the leg kicking up and bobbing. So there you go. There are the four extra little tips for DUIK that you might not have known about. I really enjoy making these videos about DUIK and shining a spotlight on these overlooked features of DUIK. DUIK really is a feature-rich tool that goes well beyond simply rigging characters, and I think it's helpful to know what you can do with it. So hopefully you'll find that these tricks are helpful and useful in your future projects. If you did find that these were helpful, please do me a favor and hit that like button so that the YouTube overlords may bless this video. If you want more content like this, of course, make sure that you are subscribed with that bell notification turned on. And if you have any questions about these features and how they work, leave those questions in the comments section and I will try my best to respond and clear up anything I didn't mention or explain well in this video. I always try to do that. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you for the next video.